Hey y'all, my name is Daniel Kraus. This is my vlog one for Life Coaching 301. Today's topic is nutrition and body composition. I decided to use the article titled Eat Right to Perform Well and Reach Your Ideal Body Composition by Orlando Health at Southlake Hospital. Basically, what this went over was how nutrition plays a big role in your body composition. They said body composition is measured in a few ways. They said one way is the BMI chart, and the more gold standard is the hydrostatic or underwater weighing, or there's more advanced ways like the dual energy x-ray or the bioelectrical impedance analysis. For those of you who don't know, BMI is body mass index. Body mass index is a arbitrary chart with a point system that measures what your body composition is based on your age, sex, height, and weight. And the point system is 18 and a half and below is underweight. 18 and a half to 24.9 is normal or healthy weight. 25 to 29.9 is overweight. And then 30 and above is obese. They also went over how your body composition affects your health. So things like blood pressure, resting heart rate, cholesterol, and blood sugar are affected by your body composition. And then they also went over how improving your body composition can be achieved through proper nutrition. And so reading over this, I realized that they are correct in a lot of ways, that your nutrition does actually play a role in your overall health. It plays a role in your performance, and it does play a role in your body composition, and then your body composition also affects your health and performance. However, I don't think I would use this specific article, though, only because I think they stressed BMI a little bit too much. I find the BMI chart to be a little bit dangerous. I don't think it's a great indicator of your body composition. And while it's a little more, you know, convenient and common to use the BMI chart, I don't find it a good indicator of body composition. For example, I'm 5'9", I'm a male, I'm 180 pounds, and I'm 21 years old. My BMI point is 27 and a half or 28, and that would make me considered overweight. I am not overweight. I have very proper nutrition and I exercise daily, so I am not overweight. So that's why I just say that I don't think BMI is a really good indicator all the time. BMI could be beneficial to the more obese or elderly population, just because they're a little more on the extreme side of the example. But if anyone were to benefit from this article, I do think it would be that population. Besides that, I would say that most people could benefit from reading this. Just because they are correct that nutrition does affect your body composition, your health, and your performance. And then this does play a really, this plays into a lot of what God tells us to do in the Bible. In 1 Corinthians 6:19, he tells us that our body is a temple and for the Holy Spirit, and that we should take care of that. And a way to do that is through proper nutrition, is through monitoring our health, our body composition, things like that. So while I probably wouldn't use this article for a client, I think it does have helpful information. And I think that it could be beneficial to people's health. And you can use this information to still glorify God and things like that. So thank you for coming to the vlog, and I'll see you in vlog 2.